how to manage data in Excel. If you have any data, like data exported from SAP, or in this case, I have a list of employees, and you're going to do manipulation with the data, like you want formulas, you want like maybe a pivot table, pivot charts, and that kind of thing. Instead of dealing with the raw data and having to redo that processing every time, you do is as soon as you export the data, don't touch the raw data. Link to it as a data table. So this raw data that I have here, I'm going to close this file for, it's on my desktop, so I'm just going to link to it. So I'll create a new file and show you how you can link to it. So from a blank sheet, if you want to link to external data, if you have a newer version of Excel, then in the data tab, there is get data from file and from workbook. And then just go and browse to the file. If you don't have this option and you have an older version of Excel, it's still possible, it's just you have to do it a different way. So in the older version, what I used to do is have to go to existing connection, even though I don't have a connection currently, and go browse for more. I have nothing listed or don't have an Excel connection. And then choose a data source, Microsoft Excel, and then browse to the file. So both ways will get you there, just this way, a little bit more indirect. So I want to bring in the sheet tab that's called employees. Often raw data will just, it'll just be called sheet one, $. And it assumes that your first row contains the heading, which in this case is true. And I'm going to have these parameters. These are your default parameters where you want the data and so on. So I don't want to get into any fancy settings, so you can just hit OK. So it brings the data in and automatically formats it with the alternate rows, different colors, blue and white. It makes it easier to read the data. So there's basically two huge advantages to doing data linking like this. One advantage is formulas. When you create a formula, it's automatically copied all the way down. And the other advantage, which I'll demonstrate first, is the speed of the drop-down filters. Even if this was 50,000 rows, when I hit a drop-down, it right away brings up a list, and only the list of names that you need to be seeing. As you page flip down, it refreshes the data, so it doesn't have to list every single row of occurrences. And if I filter, say I filter by everybody with the name starting with BE, you see how quickly it brings up the list. So if you had a huge list in standard Excel, that would have taken a long time. So speed is one major benefit. So I just go data clear to clear my filter. So the other benefit, like I mentioned, is formulas. So if I want a formula, say, to calculate how long the person's worked for the company, I'll just call that, say, years of service. See how it automatically does the formatting all the way down? So the years of service would be basically using datedif function, and it's the datedif between the date hired. And you notice it doesn't put the cell reference F2, it puts the actual field header. And so it's the difference between the date hired and now, right? Current date. So I go now, open close brackets, and I want that the display to be in the format of years. So I just put it in the format that I want the result. And you see it copied it all the way down. So not only did it copy it all the way down, I'll do a control down arrow to prove it to you. There's last row is 5001. But if the data, the raw data, increases or decreases in size, the formulas automatically are assigned to every single row. So it treats the data more like a proper database. So another formula I want to know is, say, the year, the date that their retirement, person's retiring. So retire date. So to calculate the retirement date based on the birth date plus the 65 years, and if you just do that with assuming a year is 365 days, it's not going to be the actual date. I want it to show 65 plus the year. So it'd be, instead of 1988, it would be 1988 plus 65. So it's the date of birth added 65 years. So I'd use a date function. say take the year of their date of birth. And you notice again, put the header. And I want to add 65 to that. But I also want to show the month of the date of birth. And I want to show the day of the date of birth. And that should do it. I noticed I forgot a bracket in my formula right there. So that shows 2053. That should be 65 years after 1988. Of course, if you change the retirement age of that person in the raw data, that would automatically change in the calculation spreadsheet. So again, anything you do, like you make a pivot table or a pivot chart, all the data is linked to the raw data source. As the raw data source changes, so does all your spreadsheets that are linked to it. So speed, ease of use, and it treats data proper. Hope you enjoyed this lesson.